Guess what? So I've been over here, right, editing the new episode on Dylan's laptop, and I've almost finished the whole new episode. I've been sitting down for a couple of hours and I've just smashed it out.
We're on. I just gave it CPR like some stupid girl.
Yeah, I was like desperate, and I was like YouTube. I was like all the forums, everything, called the guy. I was still looking, and I found this YouTube video of this woman
who gave it.
Who dead set said that she went into the Microsoft store in somewhere in the States, and they said they gave it CPR, that we turned it upside down and gave it 15 compressions. And I'm watching this video just like glued to the screen, like, and Dylan's out the back. He's like, is that what he's saying, that she gave her laptop CPR? I'm like, yes. Do you think she's having a lend?
Gave the top CPR, just bang bang, and then turned it around, and then gave the bottom and just boom boom, and then opened it up, boom boom, and then like, oh, I held the power and the volume button on,
which is the restart,
really hard, like just hard as I could, and like, then
works.
And then I whacked it, and then boom, jump start in the car, really.
I can't believe it. I'm still sending it away, but currently I've got a different hard drive because the other hard drive is getting pretty full, and I'm a bit skeptical that's why this laptop's struggling, is because that hard drive's like getting full.
Bang bang, boom boom. Bang bang, boom boom.
Bang bang, boom boom.
Bang bang, boom boom.
What?
Boom. 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 Bang bang, boom boom. Bang bang, boom boom. So today I pretty much did a bit of cleaning. It's so easy to clean at a marina because you've got a floating thing next to you that you can just throw shit on, and it keeps the boat uncluttered. So filling up the tanks now, water tanks, because in Malaysia the water's good for drinking. And also I hooked up the power, the boat to power, to charge up the batteries and run the fridge and stuff, and the fans, we can run fans. And the thing is, they gave us this plug that I had to wire myself without any, like, I mean, I've done generator stuff, so I know, you know, active earth and neutral and stuff like that. Lucky, but they're just giving away plugs like that to random people with boats to wire up themselves, which is all right, you know. Most yachties are smart and know how to do stuff like that.
Tonight we made pumpkin soup after our amazing sourdough. Oh my god, it's just like, it actually...
Can't eat it.
It kind of smells a bit like salami.
Yeah, my first ever sourdough attempt was a total success. Well, that's actually a lie. I wouldn't call it a total success because when I was proofing it, I put it out in the sun, but I didn't cover it with anything like damp. I just let it, like, put a tea towel over the top, so it had a bit of a draft, so the top dried out, so when I scored it right before we baked, it didn't get to rise as much, but the flavour's there. It's still fluffy. Way more bready than any of our other breads.
Fluffy, but the Guinness bread was better, like, as in the finished flavour,
yeah,
the taste is good.
But this texture is more bready than the Guinness bread. The thing about beer bread is it's really good and easy, and it's definitely bready, but compared to bread, it's more like, beer bread's more cakey, I think. It's a Friday and my laptop broke yesterday, and then I had to re-edit an entire episode that I'd already finished. And then when I went to start, you know, transfer some files from Dylan's Premiere Pro, and then he has an older version of Premiere Pro, so the thing that I edited wouldn't work, and the things I went to drag across didn't work, so then I had to like download Premiere Pro all over again, and then that took like about 7 hours. Yeah, and so it's just been this ongoing saga, and now it's 8 o'clock at night and I am now trying to upload the video, but the internet, stop it. But the internet, I don't know, it was good yesterday. It's a bit hit and miss here, so yeah. It's annoying because it's Friday and I just want to have this episode uploaded.
We've got to use this one thing Lauren showed me, but it's got so much torque. It's bloody powerful.
Anyway, what have we got going on in the...
Oh, God. I hurt my arm, see? We're waiting for this to cool down.
I have to live with this.
We've got to wait for this to cool down.
You think it's funny, but it's not.
And then we're going to pop the lid, and then we're going to wand it with this.
Well, first we're going to check how cooked the pumpkin is before we go wanding it. They call him Wanda.
We're going to do like a Thai-inspired pumpkin soup. So we sautéed some onion, garlic, turmeric, ginger, and then we added a bit of cumin, and then some stock cubes, and then we sautéed that off, and then we added the pumpkin, a little bit of water. Now we're just waiting for that to cool down. We'll add the coconut milk, probably some more cumin, maybe a bit of coriander, some paprika, and then we'll zhuzh it together with the stick blender. And then we have fresh sourdough to go on the side, and we have a skerrick of butter left. This is the last little bit of butter from the stick that Greg and Wendy gave us. Give it a poke. Is it soft?
Yeah.
Yeah. Coconut milk, paprika. Oh god, oh no, are you okay? Be careful.
It's gonna fucking work. There's more salt coming.
Yeah, a bit more cumin. Definitely more salt. Some pepper. Yeah, just go crazy on the salt. Yep. See, salt fixed it. Okay. Is that yours? Because that's really big. You might be wondering why there's a cucumber on the table. yeah, that's heaps for me. There's a cucumber on the table because it's a really good condiment to have with pumpkin soup. No, it's because I'm making cucumber water. The last of the butter. Be my guide, be my guide. If they gave me a fortune, my pleasure would be small. I could lose it all tomorrow.
What is going on here? That sounds South African.
What's going on here?
What are you doing here?
I don't know, it's hot and we're just in the marina and we don't really have much to do. Oh, we do have lots to do, but it's too hot to do real things. So we're both kind of pretending to do things.
No, what's happened? It's hot, we've got three fans on. And I've had this job that I've needed to do since we bought the boat. And I haven't done it. And now I've got this time to fluff around on level water. Decided to tackle it. And that job is it was picked up in the survey when we first bought the boat. And I haven't even done it. So it's this hose here. We don't use the holding tank that much because we're always out in the middle of nowhere, but look at that hose. Yeah, double what it is. That little hose, that big hose there, it is for the holding tank. Now, what it carries is the poo and the wee into the holding tank. I'm hoping that there's none in it.
Yeah, rope it up top there for ventilation. That is a mess, I know.
Let's get back to the job at hand. First, I will measure out the hosing that I have because I don't even know if it's long enough. And it's marked here, overboard discharge and waste disposal valve, hold, handle up,
avoid discharge, handle down, holding tank. So that's to outside seawater. This is for overboard discharge and to the holding tank. So I'm gonna close the ball valve and then unscrew. All right, seems that we're long enough.
I'm pretty sure the sizing's right as well. Same stuff, sanitation hose.
Our holding tank's dead center in the boat, in the middle of the boat, and so is our diesel tank, and they're right next to each other.
So I've ran the hose, just dummy run it, so I know it's long enough.
This is the hose here. And it runs to the one on the left there, that one. So I'm gonna try and get in there and undo that. And then from that right, that one, it goes out. Goes out to the world. So I think maybe
it's like once the tank's full, the holding tank, it might overboard discharge automatically. It's just that this hose is ready to go and I don't want poo everywhere.
So I'll probably undo it from that end first because it's higher.
See if there's any poo in there in that end. If there's poo in that end, then there's definitely poo in that end. So, oh man, I don't even know what to do. I don't know what to do if there is poo in that line and the tank's full. I can't pump the tank out. There's no way I can just, maybe I'll just have to leave that hose on and if there's poo in it. Because I don't want to deal with that stuff.
Okay, so something bad just happened. So I was going to try and get this cable tie off this hose here. I punctured that one of the bubbles and piss came out. It stinks. So there's definitely piss in there. I'm gonna have to try and stop it from coming out. Or like, you have to fill a bucket of piss and shit. What do you do? Like, how do you do these? God damn. My understanding is, if it was full of piss and other bodily fluids, then it would still be gushing out, I think. That's my, so I think these are bubbles. As bubbles just have piss trapped inside them. Otherwise, it would just be flowing out. Otherwise, if I was to take it off there, it would just gush out. I'd have to try and get it in a bucket really quick. But then there'd be piss and whatever else everywhere. So I'm going the slow approach.
Drilled a few holes.
And it stinks. And cut the hose with a Stanley knife.
Ooh, it's stinky up in here.
Oh, that came apart very easily. So like it cut very easily. So it must have been degrading.
All right, so I'm just gonna cut that off that fitting there. I know there's no more piss in there, and the hose isn't full now. So I'm just gonna take this old one out, got it unscrewed, and take him off of there, put the new one in, and I'll report back when I've got all this off, ready to put the new one in. I know what I've been told, you gotta work to feed the soul, but I can't do this all on my own. No, I know I'm no Superman. So I got the other one off. Oh man,
stinkiest thing I've ever smelled, eh? That yellow fitting there. As soon as I popped it off there, it was just...
Oh, almost wanted to vomit. I don't even know if people want to watch this sort of stuff.
There's a lot of smells in here at the moment. It's starting to put me off. I've got most of the hose out. The new one's behind me, back there. And I've just got to get the one bit that's on the tank off. I'm gonna try and get all the fluids out of that first as well, because so gross. That needs to be done, otherwise we'd be motoring along, smell piss, and come down here and there'd be urine everywhere. So there's one little thing that I noticed as well. There's one more hose that needs replacing, and guess what? That hose is for the pump out. So instead of it going to the top of the tank, of the holding tank for all the piss and the poo, it goes to the bottom. So if that guy bursts, the whole tank's gonna flood out into the engine room. Nice little job, keeping me busy. There's not a whole lot to do. We're just sort of waiting for the right weather window. Waiting for Blue Moon shirts to come in, waiting for an order for those shirts, waiting for a few other things, Lauren's laptop, and then we can take off to Arnhem Baas. And when I'm not doing these jobs, I'm probably just sitting on YouTube, watching other people sail around the world. Well, I know what I've been told, you gotta know just when to fold, but I can't do this all on my Superman. The last piece of the puzzle. No Superman. The last piece.
Line, won the race but lost your mind. No! Just get away from me. After all. Yeah.
I had to tie you up as best I could. Could only get the hose halfway up the fitting, so it should be fine. It's not a pressurized. It shouldn't be used when under the waterline anyway, so I got that new white hose.
Thanks for joining us this week. You're in for something a little different next time. Since we've got time to kill waiting on deliveries to the marina, we decided we'd take you along for a trip to Singapore. A little dose of city life is just what the doctor ordered. I'm no Superman. Sailing Blue Moon videos are made possible by our patrons and viewers just like you. If you'd like to support our content creation while receiving perks in return, you might consider becoming a patron. Or maybe you'd just like to buy us a beer or donate to the Sailing Kitty via PayPal. Every little bit counts and we'll be sure to give a shout out.
If you enjoy our content, you can help us out by liking this video and subscribing if you haven't already. Don't forget to click the bell to the right to be notified of new episodes. We'd also love to hear from you, the viewer, so hit us up in the comments below.
And lastly, you can follow us in real time on Instagram and Facebook. As always, thanks for watching, Blue Moonies.